Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. I am super excited today to talk to y'all about gravity forms. I know a lot of people have asked me over the last year or two to do a series on gravity forms, and we're gonna start it. So today we'll walk over just the simple basics of installing it and some really cool out-of-the-box elements that you can do that you might not have known was available, like styling. And then we're gonna go even further down week after week, talking about all the different add-on options and all the crazy cool features you can ultimately do with the premium plugin Gravity Forms. It's pretty darn amazing. All right, I wanna give a shout out to all of our incredible sponsors here. If you're using WordPress, which is what this tutorial is about, Gravity Forms inside of WordPress, you need to be hosting on WP Engine. They're a little bit premium price, but you get exactly what you pay for. You get a staging area, you get fast, premium security. It's amazing. And anytime you call them for support, they know exactly what you're talking about because they're only WordPress hosting. All right, you got to check them out. Then we've also got WP Elevation, which if you're an entrepreneur using WordPress, you need to be checking them out because they're going to help you understand how to better approach clients, how to improve your business, and all around become a better freelancer or even a business running on WordPress. All right, it's an incredible resource. WP 101, if you love these tutorials like what I'm doing today, you need to check them out. They have a great free library of videos as well as some premium ones. All right. So, incredible resources for you. We're gonna talk about this right here. Let me jump off the screen for a second because we're gonna talk about gravity forms. There are some free options whenever you're looking to use a form builder inside of WordPress, but gravity forms for the price point of a single license is only $40 a year. I know that sounds a little bit more premium than what you might be planning for in your budget, but I'm going to show you right now why it is so worth the value. Just phenomenal. We've done the developer license where it's unlimited sites, and I renew every single year because I like having the support and all the updates and everything that I need for my clients. So with that being said, you would purchase it from this website. Once you've downloaded it, it's the zip file. Then you're going to go to your install area on plugins. You're going to add new, and you're going to upload the file that you need. It's a zipped file, so you're going to browse and install it. Once that's complete, you'll activate it. You all know how to do a plugin. It's activated. Now on the left side of your screen, once you've activated that plugin, you're going to see, let me show you. So we've got Gravity Forms here. Now that it's activated, you're going to have a tab over here on your left navigation that says Forms. It's that simple. So we're going to pop into New Form. Now it's immediately going to prompt you for a title. So this is just going to be for demo purposes, so I'm going to say demo. If you wanted to give it a description, you're more than welcome to do that. I'm just going to go ahead for now and say create form. This beautiful environment is a drag and drop environment. That's all it is. You don't have to know nerd code to build a very, very in-depth, involved, beautiful form or something simple like a contact form. Let me show you two different forms that we have going on WebTegrity's website. So I've got this very, very simple three-field form with name, email, your message, and all of them have this little asterisk there, meaning that they're required fields, and then we've got our submit button, right? Very, very simple contact form. But you can go as advanced and crazy as you want to. You can use Gravity Forms to be a shopping cart system even. You can use it as a registration form for events where people have to pay on the spot. You can use it in anyway, you can make a directory out of Gravity Forms. It's phenomenal. You can export all your entries into an Excel file. You can, I could keep going, and we're going to. We're going to do the whole series in the next couple of weeks, so stick around and be sure to subscribe to the channel. This particular form here, you can see we have a first name field, a last name field, a company name, your title, your email. You have to confirm your email as well because they're registering for an event here. We've got a drop-down option for them to fill out and select their industry that they're involved in. Another drop-down field for their t-shirt size for the event. They have a preference for food. And then we're going to check this for, yes, I understand the refund policy. And then they're going to click register now and jump over to PayPal and pay money on the spot to register for this event. I get a notification right away that they've registered, and I get a notification from PayPal saying they've paid. They get an immediate autoresponder saying, congratulations, you've registered, here's your receipt. It's a brilliant system, and it's set up just like this. All right, so here we go. back to the forms area. So if I want to select a field and start building my forms, just read through this, all right? Just slow down for a second and read through. This is a quick tutorial as well of how to do all this, but I'll show you here visually so you can check it out. I'm going to click over to advanced fields because I want a name field initially, so I'm just going to click it. Dynamically, it's going to drop it in for me. There you go. So there's our name field. By default, it gives us these two different fields here, the first and last name. If you want a simple field, just click on the arrow, open it up, and let's make some adjustments, okay? So we don't necessarily want first and last name. Maybe we just want first. So now it's going to give us this field. And we can say anything we want to over it. So your name here gives us the little description below it. If we want above it, instead of having that there, we can get rid of that and say full name. Up above it, we can say your name. Whatever you want, you can play around with it. You can give it a description. This area goes here. Say whatever you want to there. If you want it to be required, this is all you do. Just check a simple box. That's it. And just click required. That's it. Zip up the box. Now we've got our field. And you just keep adding like that. Let's say we want a drop down option like what you saw. Let's choose a drop down. We're going to open it up and we're going to edit it. We're going to give it a title. And we're going to just do what I did on the example I showed you, t-shirt size. And so your first choice would be extra small, right? Oop. And then your next size would be small. And then your next size would be medium. And now, how do we add more fields? You simply click the plus sign. And we say large, and another plus sign. And we say XL. And then let's say we wanted to do a youth small as well, right? Well, let's say we wanted that youth small to actually be at the first field. All you do is drag and drop it up, and it reorders the system. Let's make it a required field. We absolutely want that to be there and available to us. And we're going to click Update Form. And you're building your form. That's all we're doing. We're building our form. Now we've got our name. Now we've got our t-shirt size. Let's say we want them to be able to drop in a message to us. We're just going to click Paragraph Text. And it allows a field to be there for them to just keep writing. So we can say your message, right? And do we want to make it required? Not necessarily, right? So maybe we just say optional. Just to let them know you don't necessarily have to do it. What do you say if we don't want the optional down below the box and we want it above the box? All you do is come here. All I did was go to appearance. And now it says description placement. Maybe we want it above the input, and now it's just going to be right above the box. Ah, how cool is this? Isn't that amazing? So easy, so simple. So you might be saying right now, well, where's the submit button? I don't see anything that shows that. Dynamically, whenever you create this form and put it on a page, that submit button is going to be there. What if you want to say, like I did on the other example, I don't want it to say submit, I want it to say connect today, or I want it to say register now, right? And that's the prompting you want on that submit button. You can change that like this. So I'm gonna go ahead and just click update this form so that I'm saving what I'm doing, all right? There's another area here. Let me pop off the screen again so you can just stay focused. In form settings now, we're gonna go to form settings, and this is specifically editing this one form called demo that I'm creating for you right now. Label placement, this is kind of the default label placement of where you want things to be. The description placement, default. So if you wanted to set them dynamically all the way across the board for every field on this particular form, you can do that. Here's the input type and our text over the button. So if we wanted to say register now, there you go. Now our submit button will absolutely just have that available. And then so I'm going to update the form settings. I'm going to show you one other cool thing here in a second, but let's go over and put this on a page so that you can see what this is looking like. You can actually preview it here if you wanted to. There's a little button there that just says preview so you can see how your form is looking. But I want to show you how to actually get it on a page, right? So I'm just going to add new page here, and this is just going to be test demo form. And because we've installed Gravity Forms, there's this new icon up here. Check this out right here, add form. We're going to click that. It's going to allow us to choose whatever form we have here. I've made many, many forms. So I'm going to check our demo. I don't want the form title to display, and I don't really want the description to display either. And I'm going to insert the form. Dynamically, it creates this short code for me and allows me to see exactly what this form is going to look like, sitting on my website. How pretty is that? I've set some styling in my CSS file to make the button be orange, so yours is probably going to look a little different on your website. But here's the form with my drop-down beautifully created. Here's my optional message. They can click register now. How neat is this, right? So there's all sorts of other really cool things. One of the things I'm going to show you right now, scrolling down here, sometimes people want to have a CAPTCHA or the little field, you know, where people have to fill it out to prove that they're a human being and not a robot. And some people cannot stand those. So if they see it on a form, they don't even fill out the form. They get irritated, they move away. Or they can't figure out what the code is and they get irritated and they move away. We don't want that to happen. We want this to be no fear in filling out our form. So one of the coolest things about Gravity Forms is it has this really cool little option here that says enable anti-spam honeypot. What that is that's a hidden field behind the scenes that sits there, and if a robot comes to your site, it cannot tell that that is a hidden field. So it's going to fill it out and click submit. Well, the system knows Gravity Forms is so smart that it knows that's a spammer. They're going to take that and dump it and not even allow it to hit your website. How incredible is that? It's kind of reverse CAPTCHA, right? Ah, so cool. All right. I've taken up my 10 minutes and more. I'm not going to bore you anymore. I hope this was exciting for you, but I tell you what, next week I'm going to take you into styling the form. I'm going to take you into some add-ons the following week. It is going to get good, so be sure to click subscribe down here in this little corner over here. Click that little button. Hang out with me next week. I'll see you next WordPress Wednesday. Bye-bye, y'all.